Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Delta Force 2. We are going to tackle a new operation today called Operation Global Enforcement. And the scenario is something like a recent addition to the terrorist mix, United Freedom, has begun uranium mining operations in Chad. It is believed that this is the first step in a plan to manufacture their own nuclear weapons. Your team will immediately begin operations to shut the terrorists down. So that's essentially, you know, the basic narrative of this entire campaign called Global Enforcement. The first mission and the only mission in Chad that is unlocked to us is Mission Claim Jumper. So terrorists have taken control of a uranium mine in Chad, capture the mine and stop the flow of unregulated uranium. So yeah, I mean, it could be used to make nuclear bombs, so that's pretty much the big issue right here. I would have thought that uranium mines would be better guarded, but I suppose it is what it is. Anyway, that's as straightforward as of a synopsis as we can hope to get. Let's check the... let us go ahead and check the mission briefing. I pressed the B button instead of power.
We have a new problem. CIA sources tell us that the terrorist group United Freedom has taken over a uranium mine in Chad. We believe that they are mining the ore to sell on the world market or to use as raw materials for their own weapons of mass destruction. We need to stop this flow of unregulated uranium and capture the mine intact. Your mission is to eliminate all hostiles in the area and retake the mine. Your insertion point will be 500 meters south of Objective Manhattan. All teams will converge on the mine. We do not know how long they have been in control of the area, but satellite photos indicate that a defensive perimeter has been erected at the site. There's also a blockade on the main road. Good luck.
Good luck indeed. You need luck for any of these missions in Delta Force. However, it seems like a pretty straightforward mission. Just go ahead and eliminate everybody. That being said, there seem to be a lot of people on this mine, and I do not see any backup from Alpha and Charlie teams for me. This is Bravo 1 going solo. And there also seems to be a helicopter right here, which seems a little disconcerting, to be honest. So, yeah. Let us go ahead and change the gear then. And I would rather not prefer the shotgun, I would prefer the grenade launcher. A law, I think, for the helicopter would be a necessary choice. Now, let us start this mission.
All King Elements. We need to secure the uranium mine.
We actually ran faster with the knife equipped. I thought it was only a CSGO thing. Or like a CS thing. I guess all the old games did it.
King Six, this is Black Widow. All teams on the ground.
No, that was just an illusion. That's not really good food.
Bravo, you are compromised.
I know.
Proceed with the mission. I say again, proceed with the mission.
Good. I got them all. Nobody ran this time. So this is attempt number 6, I do believe, if I'm not wrong. Alpha 1 and 2 are going to be accompanying us to a degree, and then they'll head off their own way. To die, essentially. Best way to play this game is to use the perimeter to neutralize all hostiles and then close in, neutralize the rest from up close. Well, I say all, but I really mean as many hostiles as possible. Because it's sort of difficult to neutralize them all. Neutralized him. Oh, there he is. Right. I sort of got the positions of enemies down by now, for being the reason why I'm shooting so freely. There's some more enemies to our right. I'm just gonna crouch here. I wonder if that's an enemy. That was an enemy. Guess what? Somebody shooting from over there. Let's take this opportunity to do this.
Bravo,
secure Objective Manhattan, that's it. And Alpha Team was going to be down anyway. I mean, the way they play so recklessly, there isn't really any other outcome for them, except for them to die. Very, very poor deaths. Now, I'm not dissing on them, but it sort of is the truth, because they play very rashly. I'm getting shot at from all over the place. Ah, I see. I sort of forgot about those guys there. It's strange. The game played the dry fire sound, but then it just went ahead and played the fire. It just fired around anyway. Okay, that was another guy there. Unless that was like... Okay, that was another guy. Okay, that was nice. Couldn't really see him there, but that was really nice. There's an enemy right there, okay. Somebody else is shooting at me from elsewhere. Probably that guy next to the barrel there. Thank you for coming. It was nice to have you. But we all gotta die sometime. Sadly, today was your day. Today was your turn. More enemies here somewhere. I'm getting shot. I was getting shot, rather. Bullet whizzed past me again. I can't tell from where, but it did whiz past me. Pretty certain there would be more enemies along that line over there. Is that an enemy? I think it is. It was an enemy. Lag. It's like the GPU just sort of stops processing for a while. The way that the lag works in this game, I mean. Oh, shooting at me from here. I hear somebody over there. That's like the strange part. Over there. Which is what I cannot figure out, because... Oh wait, there is somebody there? What? How did that happen? I thought I killed you. Apparently not. A bad place to be stuck doing lag, but oh well, we worked it out. We negotiated a release, so to speak, in diplomatic terms. Now, there can be enemies somewhere in here. You don't really know where until the time that you get close to it. So, that's there. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hook left, go up there. Eliminate all the hostiles that I can from over there. Then I'm gonna come back here, go up there. Actually, you know what? Since we're here, might as well go up there. And apparently you do suffer fall damage from this game. You can actually fall and die. Like, in this game. You literally can just fall and die. That is not something that I've known about it. Because I don't think Delta Force 1 add any fall damage. Delta Force 2 does, you just don't know how much damage you're getting from each fall. But be assured you are getting damage with each fall. And with all the sniping that I'm doing in this mission, I feel like I should have probably just went ahead and gotten a sniper. So, well, I can't exactly get a sniper because I need the grenade launcher for room clearing. But yeah, sniper might just have been better. Somebody's shooting from across the map. I can't tell where that person is, but somebody's shooting from across the map. I mean, if I had a sniper, I probably would have been able to tell. I'm just gonna shoot in all of these windows and check for myself who exactly it is that is shooting at me. Oh, in there. Don't worry, we'll get to you. We will get to you. We will will rock you. So the last time around, I was trying to get to that refinery tower, and I essentially just got shot by somebody. Actually, no, that was the last time. The last time I fell down a cliff and died. So, just goes to show you how dangerous this game is. I mean, I would have thought that it was pretty obvious that that is the thing that can happen, but I never, you know, thought that it would happen this game with the way it's structured and everything. Should be one over there. Did I shoot you dead yet? I think I did. Good. I'm just peeking out to see if there are any enemies nearby that we can get rid of. The bad thing about this level is that enemies can peek out from a lot of places, essentially. So I see an enemy marked on the map right here. Let me just go ahead and neutralize them before they become a nuisance. I think they're in this building. At least that's what the intelligence tells me. This guy has been neutralized. So that's where the enemy is, reportedly. So what do I do here? Do I chuck in a grenade? I suppose I do. A little too high. I suppose that did not work. Alright, we'll just get rid of them later. For now, let's just focus on the enemies that we can get. And of course, there's lag. Now, if the game was lag-free, it would be far less frustrating to play. But with the amount of lag in this game, it's like you take two steps and you need to wait like 10 entire seconds before you can proceed. Just because of how much the game lags. I know, you're eager for a fight. Good thing about that tent though is that it more or less just ignores bullets, so you can shoot enemies through them. If you can tell where they're shooting at you from, you can shoot at them. And just eliminate them, alright. There's also supposedly one enemy there that, well, Alpha 1 took care of. Or so I think so. I'm just shooting at all the tables to get rid of anything for the terrorists to hide behind, essentially. Alpha 2, that is one of the buildings that gave me trouble last time. Difficult to tell where the enemies are in this game. They aren't always, you know, very cut and dry that way. Like this guy right here. We didn't even see that guy until he spawned in. And that's true for a lot of these enemies. You don't see them until they spawn in. We are out of raw ammunition. So what we can do here is try and drop some bombs on these tents and get them to blow up. That gets rid of anybody inside. So that we can now focus our energies on whoever is outside. Now it says there's somebody over here in this here building. Problem is, I haven't seen them yet. There's one dead enemy there. Maybe if we can like check a grenade down there. A little higher. did not work. Okay, let us begin a cursory sweep then. There are going to be more enemies that get spawned spontaneously. You don't really have control over it. You can't really see them until they spawned either. So it's just one of the quirks of this game. It spawns in enemies for you. Intel will not locate them for you. You just have to sort of be ready for them when they do spawn in. Lagging again. Intel says there's an enemy here, and I'll tell you something. There he is. Once we get into any of these buildings, more enemies will spawn that will essentially attack us. For instance, let me just get into this building. And there will be two enemies that start running towards us on cue. Like this building spawns an enemy, and the next building over spawns another enemy without fail. They will always come and try to attack you without exception. We just need to wait here until the other guy arrives and tries to attack us. I think that's an enemy. Got him. Now what I'm gonna do is run over to the other building there. I'm just gonna stand here for a bit and check to see if any enemies are there. As soon as my frames run, that is. Yeah. So I'm just gonna keep checking these buildings for enemies. Sometimes they get really lucky with their shots. Pretty certain we took care of anybody that was in there, but I'm just gonna go and check nonetheless. It does not hurt to be cautious. What does hurt to be is rushed, and rushed is the one thing we are not going to be. Now this is another place that can give you a significant amount of cover while you check on the enemies. For some reason, I don't really want to hit those tanks. They look like they are uranium tanks, and I don't really want to cause a chain reaction. Not that it will cause a chain reaction, that's not how nuclear fission works. But you never know how the game logic is implemented, right? Okay, going up another level to where we can see the entirety of this map, and we also have the maneuverability to go side to side and check these places for any enemies from unconventional angles that we had not considered checking from before, like from over in this corner here. No enemy spotted. I don't think there are any enemies there, but again, we never know. If the game does not end after having cleared that village, if we should be lucky enough to do so, we'll go in there and check. Lag again. But this is another frustrating part of this game. The fact that lag can occur at any time, and you have no say in when it occurs, how it occurs. You're just in for the ride, along with the lag. Now you see this building right here? Watch an enemy spawn right as I get next to it. I think I've shot any enemies that might have been in here. Just shooting, just to be sure. I do not like... walking around with such little cover. But well, not a lot can be done in these cases. All I have in my favor is just movement for my own cover. That's not where I'm being shot from, that much I'm certain of. Oh, there he is. There's somebody in that building there. We don't know where yet, but there's somebody in that building there. Bad thing is we can't even shoot the door out to see where that guy is. I was hoping that they would have come up with a mechanism to shoot doors down in this game by now, but or at least, you know, destroy doors, but I suppose that's a little too much to ask for. Look at this enemy spawn right in front of me. Remember how I showed you this building and told you that an enemy was going to spawn right there? Well, he has spawned. You can see him on the map. I don't honestly know how to approach this situation, because no matter how I do it, it's going to turn into a quick draw in either way. He typically stands right in front of this door here, but apparently this time around he's over there. Interesting. I guess that's one guy down. Nobody's here this time around. I hear some folks moving about. I can't tell where they are. I'm just trying to be cautious right here. Now, I wonder sometimes whether I suck at this game because I suck at CSGO. Or like just CS in general. Because that's just one of the games where I suck. I completely suck at that, suck at CS. So I sometimes wonder whether I actually suck at this game because I suck at CS. And honestly, I haven't really been able to find an answer to it. I would suppose that we have killed everybody here, but secure object in Manhattan. The fact that the mission has not ended sort of tells me that there might just be somebody in here that needs killing. Ah, you right there, for example. And who else? Anybody else? Not that I can see. I've got grenades. Oh, come on. Really? You're gonna do me like that? I'm just doing that to be safe. Clear. This hall is clear. This hall is also clear. I'm just gonna go up and go ahead, go up. So that I can hopefully get some sort of a vantage point on the rest of these buildings here. And what I hope for is the fact that I don't die while I'm searching through these buildings. Because, you know, in this game it's pretty easy to do so. It is very easy to die when you're going through buildings. Is that guy dead? I sure hope he is. Because if that guy isn't, then, well, nobody's dead really. That looks like a dead guy. I do not see anybody here. You know, I would have thought that I have completely scoured this area. But if there are still some enemies remaining, then the only other potential source could be this tent here, which I'll go ahead and destroy. And short of that, we did go through all of these houses, didn't we? So short of all that, only two options remain now. One is that the enemies are actually... We have been into this house, have we? I think we have. Is that it?
The mine is secure.
Yes.
Good job, Bravo.
Finally. Finally. After 6 tries. And it took me 1.5 hours to complete this mission. 1.5 hours. Says something about this game though. Anyway, let's end this mission then. That was that for Mission Claim Jumper. My god, for a mission that starts off an operation, namely Operation Global Enforcement. That mission was difficult. I did not expect that mission to be that difficult. So, in turn, it has unlocked 2 other missions for us. One is Supernova and one is Critical Mass. Both of which sound very, very, very dangerous. And honestly, I don't even want to look at what the briefings have to say for those missions either, like right now. So yeah, that was that for Mission Claim Jumper. I had to try and retry that mission half the time because I didn't know where the enemies were shooting from, half the time because, well, the enemy got lucky, or I got unlucky by essentially eating myself off a cliff. I mean, I didn't even eat myself off a cliff, I just jumped down like a story, and because I'd done that a few times over, my character just decided to die. So that happened, and then, you know, finally we succeed. So, well, good job to us. I sort of feel like I deserve it because I've been on this single mission for the past 1.5 hours, if I hadn't said that already. But anyhow, that was it for Mission Claim Jumper, which I don't know what that means. I'm guessing it's some sort of insurance fraud term. But anyhow, or maybe it's a nuclear physics term, because that seems to be, you know, not even nuclear physics, just like a physics term. That sort of seems to be the theme, the ongoing theme in these missions here. But anyhow, when we come back, we will be covering either Supernova or Critical Mass, depending upon the description of these missions and which one seems more urgent or pressing. As for this video, this was it. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for sticking around until the end. And yeah, until next time. Take care. Farewell, fellow Wolfgangs.